Hey guys, so I know I've been a bit quiet lately. I've just been very busy with varsity work and drilling. But I thought it'd be pretty cool to do a video on the local talent we have in South Africa. So here are my top 5 South African musicians. Queen, watch her paint her face on. Number 5 is Seether. They are SA's most successful band, formerly known as Sarin Gas. They moved from Johannesburg to America, I think in 2001, and they had to change their name due to some legal issues, I think. They made it very big there with hits such as Broken, which features the lead singer of Evanescence, Fine Again, and 1690. I used to be very, very into them in about grade 6, 7, and 8. So around 12 to 14, I was very into hard rock and metalcore during that time of my life. So yeah, I really dig Seether. I don't listen to them that much anymore, but they are definitely worth checking out. So go look them up. Crackers, tabernacle, blacks, blacker than the blackest black. Audible, disaudible, sportable in the beggar's hand. Fingers flick, zap the opposition with the laser weapon. Usable in any opposition when I eat the record. Whoops, you've landed on a planet called Platinum. If you make the wrong decisions, inhabit a spine of an habit. Sing us on the avalanche, take my mystical dragon hand. Blubber your troubles to other bubbles, but that manic man. Girl, I love you so much. Jump on the fucking, jump on the fucking, jump. Okay, number 4 is PH Fat. They are an electronic rap. I don't even know how to categorize their genre really, but yeah, it's like electronic rap. It's very dark themes they rap about. I've seen them live so many times, from Oxbridge to Belize to Brazenhead to Pet Rage to boat races. I've seen them live so many times. There's actually a saying amongst people in South Africa. If it's the first time seeing PH Fat live, she's probably too young for you. When I was at Pledge Rage in end of 2014, I actually was hitchhiking because I didn't want to walk home after the draw. Managed to hitch a ride with the lead singer of PH Fat, so that was pretty sick. His car was quite messy and it smelled quite a lot of like cigarettes, but yeah, this is really nice of him, so that was sick. My favorite songs from PH Fat, 1989. Jump, obviously, and Kill the Universe. The duo have recently broken up and split off into Notch Beats, which was the guy who made the music, and then the lead singer by himself, who just still performs under the PH Fat name. Number 3! It's 'cause we're skinny white kids with no cash or friends or fans. Finkelsteins, nickname the Finks. They're actually from my hometown, or where I live now as well, Port Elizabeth, PE. They were from the early to mid 2000s era. They were a pop punk alternative rock band, but perhaps a bit more alternative rock. They were known for being goofy and making silly jokes on stage and having very good like banter between the guitarist and the bassist. They were making it very big in South Africa, and they had a lot of potential to become, I feel, one of the biggest bands in South Africa. However, the bassist decided to leave the band to live a more chilled life because he found touring to be quite hectic. So unfortunately they had to break up because they really are a cool band. Their albums, The Dawning of a New Era, and then their album The Finkelsteins vs. Rock and Roll, which I think is actually one of my favorite albums. And favorite songs from them is Rock and Roll, Stick in the Mud. On to number 2. And I'll find mine on the right of your side. And I'll find mine on the right of your side. If I throw away my fear and pride to set things right. And I'll find mine on the right of your side. Okay, I'm sure all the South Africans watching and perhaps a few overseas people
know who this guy is. Matthew Mole really has taken South Africa by storm over the past few years. First time I saw him was through a Facebook link of a live performance he had with Just Music SA, or on their YouTube page. And I was like, wow, this guy's like pretty good, but I just didn't see him as becoming like such a star, not because his music wasn't great, just because at the time South African music, there wasn't really like much going on at the time. The first time I saw him live was at the Grainy Sound Festival, which was really amazing because I had the album before I saw him live, and I missed the opportunity to see him live when he played in PE because I was too late to buy tickets. A lot of his songs are very relatable to me, as he sings a lot about God and Christianity, but in a different way than the normal worship songs you might hear at church. He almost sings them in a way that just relates to life, daily life in general. My favorite songs from him are, of course, Take Yours, I'll Take Mine, which you saw now in the video, Free and Untorn, and then perhaps my favorite song from him is The Wedding Song. I just think it's so beautifully written. It's about his now wife, Jess, I think that's her name, and it's got one of my favorite lines because it really helps me sometimes when I just don't understand the whole Christianity thing. The line is, and I can't profess that I understand it, but I see me holding your hand with the your being God. You can check out his latest single Run from his new album Run. It's gained quite a lot of views on YouTube. It's really such a rad video and a cool song. Before we get to number one, here are some honorable mentions.
I'm a ninja. Yo, my life is like a video game. My main thing when I'm in the zone. One player, one life in the mark. I'm with the dog.
Go, ninja. Go.
I can see the light that it hollowed out my eyes. I can see the light. Dear God, it's beautiful.
She always gets what she wants. She always gets what she needs and more.
He body for this old day school. Yo, he don't be cruel with the style.
Just like the sun needs the moon, and just like the spring needs summer, that I will be your ocean.
Don't go.
The winner is my band, Dead End Dreamers. No, really, is number one.
Each time she's in a fix, she'll weasel her way out. Jedi mind tricks. Every time she's in a bind, suddenly I realize, go zoom the world.
Tweak were a pop punk punk rock band from the late 90s to early 2000s. They were essentially the Blink 182 of South Africa, and obviously I was too young then to actually know what Tweak was or music really, but just speaking to some of my older friends who were teenagers during that time period have explained to me that literally all the teenage girls loved them and all the guys liked them. One of the biggest bands in South Africa at the time. Their albums are called The Romantic Lure of Possum Worship, which is a bit more punk rock than their second album, which is Dirty Sanchez and The Misfit Kids, which is, I would say, much more pop punk. Just like Blink and the Finkelsteins, they were almost rude, immature, silly, kind of in your face, with the whole motto of never growing up, staying young, which is really relatable to me at this age. My favorite songs from them, Birthday Card, Sweet Memories, House Party, and my favorite song from them, Tide, is My Favorite Girl and The A-Team. The song you just heard now was Girls Rule the World, where if you listen to the whole song, it's almost got like a bit of soft rap, which Tweek actually did quite a lot. They brought hip-hop influences into the punk rock, pop-punk sound, so it was really something different. The A-Team, which I mentioned now, was released last year because they broke up in 2005. So last year was their 10th anniversary and they came back for a tour around South Africa, dressed in all the clothes they used to wear. And yeah, apparently it was really well supported, according to what I saw on Facebook. My cousin in Cape Town went to go see them, super jealous, because he grew up, he was a teenager when they were big, so he knew all the songs. Yeah, sounds really cool. So thanks for watching my first video in quite a while. Hope you enjoyed it. Subscribe below to keep up to date with my videos and the content I'm releasing. Let me know what you think in the comments as well.
Not the Ghostbusters.
What about your mom?
Hell no, I can't trust her. With all of the abuse, you know why?
Sometimes it is, but when she's got a face like she does, you go and start.